Hello, right, YouTube, this is going to be a video, not a how-to video, but it's a video of how I'm going to make an axe sheath. This is for Brian Gillies, and this is what it's going to look like. Got it marked out there. Just watching a video on YouTube at the minute. I like bushcraft, seems alright. Here's my mic. Alright, let's crack on. It's gonna be the sheath. Got some brass Chicago screws here. Can't find my knife, so I've nicked my missus. Bit of flower power, show the love. Keep it bushcrafty or flowery. Once that's all cut out, I'll cut the welt out this side here. Well, got some dye as well. Punch the holes with this leather punch. And for the strap, we've got another piece of leather here, a bit thinner. I think this leather is about 3 mil. Yeah, I think that's 3 mil. And this is like 2 mil, 1.5 mil thick. So that'll make the lace that threads through there and there. And then you pull them tight, then it wraps around the back of the axe head, around the back of there, it does. That sheath's off this one, this is the Otis 4's HY10. Right there then, so next thing is I'll cut it out. As soon as I cut it out, I'll mark the welt, and then I'll bring you back when it's all cut out and that, and I'll mark the studs where they're gonna be, and then we'll dye it. Let that dry, and then we'll put it all together. We will, and see what it looks like. Hopefully, it'll look all right. I've never made one like this before. I've made other ones, but they have been like these. This is a Husqvarna hatchet. It is. This is like one of my first attempts at doing sheaths years ago. But this one was just a rip off of that one, really. This one started off with a strap going around the back and going there, and I needed the strap for another thing. I can't remember what it was, but I took the strap off and just got some leather thong and just whipped it through. This is my braid axe with a Grancers Brooks handle on, but I've got a Grancers Brooks. This one, if you can see it, I don't think you can. Says Braid Company 1918. Right there then, I'll bring you back once I've cut it all out, and I'll see you in a bit. Right then, so I've cut it out, There's the welt. Yeah, right, fuck up on that. I didn't mark that properly, but I've marked out along the edge and I've just got to punch the holes now. Punch the holes out there and there. Let's see. Guy, I was going through now. Going through lovely. Right, I'll bring you back when it's all finished. Well, I'm gonna mark it up next. Right, our next thing we're gonna do now is we're going to stain the leather, and that gives a good staining. Got a sponge. To the inside as well. All the edges. Sponge is falling apart. Alright, so we'll let that dry, or the welt as well to do. So we'll let that dry. And then give it another coat. I don't think it will need another coat on the the inside because it's dark enough. But on the outside, should need another coat. Shouldn't take long. It looks pretty dry now, look. Ah, shut it, let's get another coat. All the edges again. Oh, there, that looks all right now. Just let that dry. Let that dry, and it should be ready for putting together. Yeah, looks magic. Righto, see you in a bit. Right, just cut the lace and then just put in a point on it like that, same that side, give this a quick coat as well. And let that dry as well. Can't find a glove, so I'm just using a clear plastic bag. Yeah, I still get fucking dye on my fingers, look. Right then. Wait for these to dry and then we'll come back. Come back, put it together, see how it looks, if it needs a sanding or anything like that. I ain't got no burnishing tools, but I think it'll look nice when it's finished. I think this might need another coat because it's a bit patchy in places. So I might give that a go now. It's had three coats now.
And this should be the final coat. Give it a quick wipe as well. That look, yeah, give that a quick blast over the welt. And we'll let that dry again. So I'll see you in a bit.
Right there then, now that's all dry,
let's put it together. So I'm using brass Chicago screws. Put it up a bit. How's that? Brass Chicago screws. So let's put it together. I'm back in a minute, find a better screwdriver. Righto, so we got the first bit on. Let's put the rest on. Fiddly bit this is. Try and keep all the screws uniform, not going one way. last screw. Is that now for the lever? Pardon me. I need me leverman for this. Here we go. One bit through now. Now back through there. The holes aren't quite big enough, but it's the biggest hole that I've done on the right, back in a minute. Right, so I managed to get through the first bit. Now it's the second bit to get it through now. It's really tight. Oh, that just flew through there, that did. Like it was made for it. Alright then, that one goes through that last bit there. This just don't want to go. Oh, it has now. It's way tight, that is. But it should, as soon as you thingy it all. Should be alright. Feed it through here. Tie it off. A simple knot. That knot up. And there we go. It's just got to be thingy through now. But once it's been used and once it's had a few pulls through and worked and. Together, it will slide back through. Oh, Jesus, that's tight. Go. Right then. Job done. Let's compare it to the original, what we took the pattern from.
Here we go, here's the original. And there's one we just made. Still tight, but that was tight once I but soon as it's been pulled through a few times, and it it'll loosen and come good. You can stand it up. That one's slightly bigger because his axe head is bigger than the one what I've got, so there you go, Brian. Hope you like it. I sent you a private message on YouTube about my Skype and that. There we go. Took an hour. Time is it? Half three, yeah. An hour. But the only thing is, I messed up. I hope you don't mind, but I got a little nick up here. But it shouldn't be too much. But soon as you stick your axe in, that'll straighten out. And tell you what, I might start making these. What do you think, YouTubers? I've got to get my spacings better, I think. But, yeah. If you want one, let me know. And I'll make you one. Awesome. Okay then. Thanks for watching. And I'll catch you most probably, might be out tomorrow. Me and Alfie Bushcraft. Okay. See you later.